Good morning.
Good morning.
Welcome this morning to worship. I'm so glad to have you here. It's good to be here today. We have a couple of announcements before we get started. Christmas Eve worship services are in all four of our churches at Frankfurt's at 5, at Washington it's at 6, in Blue Rapids it's at 6:30, and Marysville at 8. So you'll be able to worship on Christmas Eve. Pick your time, come and join us. We'll have a wonderful service. Advent Bible study is still going on. You can join us on Zoom, and if you are here joining us online and you're interested, just leave me a note or message us, and we'll make sure you get the Zoom link. We have on next week a blue Christmas service.
I'm sorry, the clicker's not working.
That's okay.
Okay.
There it goes. Okay, we'll do blue Christmas service December 21st in Washington at 6 p.m. and December 22nd in Frankfurt at 6 p.m. And a blue Christmas service is an opportunity to just spend some time in your grief or your loss. So sometimes the holidays are joyful for people, and sometimes they're just filled with some grief. Next Sunday on the 19th is a congregational meeting for both Blue Rapids and Marysville. And so we have that to do. And I believe that covers us for all of our announcements that I have. Are there any announcements for the good of the group that I missed? Okay. Then I invite you now to come into worship. We will begin worship with the lighting of our Advent. Deeply planted in the mystery of life is God's love gracing the world with presence and purpose.
We wait longing for the day of God's new dawn. We prepare, trying to make room, expectant yet despairing, hopeful yet wondering. God too longs for the world's transformation. God too prepares, making us into vessels of light and love, getting us ready to receive a new gift.
Deeply planted in the mystery of life is a stream of living water filling dry lands and dry people. Today we are blessed to have our children for our children's program. But before we do that, let us take a moment to confess before God our sins, the things that are hurting, the longings on our heart. When skin is not enough to contain you, and words cannot hold you, and religion is too shallow to know you, and theology too vague to meet you,
Be born of Jesus. Be born as love among us, for there we meet Emmanuel.
When the stable is not big enough, and the story too familiar, and the season too busy, and the time not yet right,
be born of Jesus. Be born as justice among us, for there we meet Emmanuel.
When the longing is too great, and the waiting too long, and a promise too disturbing for our way of living,
be born of Jesus. Be born of living among us, for there we can meet Emmanuel.
Friends, the story of the Nativity comes to us and reminds us that we are each loved and forgiven. Thanks be to God. Please stand as we sing Gloria.
Oh. be enrolled with Mary.
I am honored.
His wife, who is going to have a baby.
Thank you.
sheep.
Amen.
They praised God for all they had heard and seen. And Joseph.
Joseph.
Name the baby.
Aww.
Jesus. Then wise men.
Wise men.
From the east came to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is the King of the Jews? For we have seen his star and have come to worship him."
Practice that reminds us and enables us to relive God's presence.
Through story, we pass on our hopes, our dreams, the promises of God, and this story, the Christ's birth, whether told in the traditional way or the way we did today, needs to be told. It needs to be heard by us again and again, and needs to be passed on because this world is in need of a good story. So when you see our children, make sure that you tell them a good job and thank them for sharing the story today. I imagine you have your own movie lineup as you go through Christmas time. One of my favorites is the Charlie Brown Christmas. Does anybody watch Charlie Brown Christmas on holidays? Right? And there's that famous scene where Linus is standing and he says, "I'll tell you what Christmas is all about." And he stands on the stage and he drops his blanket and he recites the story. I always think that this is perfect. Because in a world that is broken, this story is an anchor. And it reminds me that there is more to the season than I even know. It reminds me that God came for this world, this broken, messy, frustrating world, and reminds me who we are to God. We are ones loved by God. In confirmation recently, we talked about how God decided to love us before we were even born. This Christmas story is a reminder of that love. God came for us, born for us, before we even had a chance to respond. When we tell a story in that broken world, then it matters. Because the world is broken and the world is hurting. And the world is in need of love. Christmas time is a time when we can be reminded of that love. So tell the story and share God's love with this broken world. Friends, I was going to have our confirmation students collect the offering today, but I sent them all out to help the kids. So we will be taking offering. There are plates and envelopes in the back. They are designated for each church. So please pick up an envelope for your church and put your offering in there if you'd like. The story is simple. God offered God's own self to us in love, and we respond to that love through our gifts of time, talent, and treasure. If the usher can come and bring the offering forward, that would be great.
Thank you, Lord, for our friends and families, for get-togethers and parties, for fun.
There will be many who have no one to visit or who find this time of year difficult, sad, and isolating. Lord, we pray that one day we will learn to be sensitive to others who feel differently from us and be open to listening to them and making time for them. Thank you, Lord, for words, for giving us a way to express ourselves. Remind us that not everyone has the freedom to use the words the way we do. Lord, we pray that one day everyone will be free and use words without fear of consequences they might bring. Thank you, Lord, for simple pleasures, for cold, dark mornings, warm, snuggly blankets. Remind us that not everyone likes the darkness or has a place to keep warm and dry. Lord, we pray that one day everyone will find light, even in the darkness, and they will have a safe place, a warm place. Lord, in your mercy, hear all our prayers. And now in the words the Lord has taught us, we pray, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. I invite you now to stand and say the words of benediction with me. We go nowhere by accident. Wherever we go, God is sending us. Wherever we are, God has put us there. He has a purpose for us being there. Christ lives in us and has something he wants to do through us. We believe this and go in his grace.